Again, you all are welcome in my channel. Today I will tell you how to design a layout as well as the stick diagram in VLSI design. And this is a very important question, and several times it is asked in the exam how to design a layout and a stick diagram. And many faculty members, they are little bit confused how the stick diagrams are different from the layout design. So this is one of the lecture that I give as an expert in Jodhpur Engineering College. So I'll just share this knowledge with all of you, so that someone who are in BTech final year and a VLSI student, they are easy to design this layout and stick diagram. So without wasting time, let us start this video and we'll see how stick diagram and the layout are different from each other. And one request to all of you to just watch this video till end, because this is a very important topic and I want you should not miss any of the things in this video. Thank you.
Ajay, I am audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are audible, sir. You just start the recording also.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. If you face any problem, you just tell me in between. Otherwise, I'll be continue with my lecture, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I will tell you.
Okay. Now. Good morning, guys. Actually, I am Dr. Pawan Vik, and Ajay requested me to give a lecture on design rules and how to design a stick diagram and how to design a layout. Many times, first of all, let me tell you about my lecture. I will not give you any presentation lecture where you feel bored. I will practically perform how to design the layout as well as the stick diagram. And most of the time, the students, and not only the students, but the teachers are also confused between these two terms, how the stick diagrams are different from the layout diagram or the layout design, actual layout design. So let me elaborate, first of all, how they are different from layout design and the stick diagram. And this is a very important question which will be asked in the exam also. So let me start. First of all, this is the CAN book. I deliberately using this book for you, just to tell you everything is given in your book. You can later on you can read it or from your book also. So let me start this. First of all, you all must have to know what are the design rules, what is the meaning of design rules, and what are the why they are used, why we used it, because there are several questions in the mind of the students. First of all, if we are talking about micron, if we are talking about the technology, there is a word technology in the CMOS, technology. What is the meaning of this technology? See, technology means, if we are talking about technology like nanometer or micrometer, what do you understand with this term, nanotechnology or a micron technology? What do you understand with this term? Let me explain this first. See, technology nothing but it is the width of the the channel that we used. That is what we call the technology. If we are talking about the nanotechnology, femtotechnology, or micron technology, it means the length of the channel that we used for designing a particular, MOSFET or a particular MOSFET. That is what we call technology. So if there are basically two kinds of design rules. One is what we call micron rules. This is the earlier rule that we are used for designing layout. But in industry, there is in physics, we have CGS, MKS, and FPS units, and MKS is the SI unit In the same way, micron rules are the rules which are followed in the industry. But later on, to make it uniform throughout the industry, we make it our lambda rules. The lambda rules which specify, in lambda rules, every dimension is particularly mentioned in the terms of lambda. So here it is also mentioned here, lambda based layout design rules were originally devised to simplify the industry standard that I told you. Earlier in the industry, they used micron rules. Micron rules means everything they manage, everything, every distance in the, you know, every distance for designing a layout, they mentioned it in microns. Microns means 10^-6. So whether it is a contact length, whether it is a distance between the poly and the contact, anything that is described in the micron rules earlier in the terms of micrometer. But you know, it is very difficult to, you know, learn what these microns values, because if the micron values is like 5.6, 10^-6, so it is very difficult to understand 2 gram, basically 2 gram, this micron rules, it is very difficult. So later on, what we do, we replace this micron rules with the lambda rules. Now everything is in the terms of lambda. I'll show you how. See, okay, see, this is a layout design rule that you have to understand. That's right. Yes, this is a layout design rule that you have to understand first. This is the minimum active area width is 3 lambda. Minimum active area spacing is 3 lambda. This is for active area rules. This is polysilicon. This is metal rules. This is a contact rules. So these all you have to learn first of all to design a layout. Because layout, let me explain the difference between the layout and the layout and stick diagram. Now in stick diagram or layout, the only difference is that in layout you have to, you know, use all the dimensions, you have to mention all the dimensions. So, and stick diagram is just like a, you know, rough diagram. It is a rough diagram on which it is a rough diagram by which, you know, one can design layout, final layout we can design with the help of stick diagram. So whenever it comes to the design, we always, the engineers, they always, you know, draw the stick diagram first, because it is easy to draw and there is no, you know, fear of dimensions. You have to just draw that's why it is called stick diagram, and you need not to be care about the dimension here. But for designing an actual layout, you have to be careful about the all the dimension. How, what are the dimension and what the, how we can design it, let us see. First of all, I'll advise you all, this is a CAM, this is a book, this is a chapter from the CAM, page number 38. If you have a ebook, it's okay. Otherwise I'll send it across the, you know, I'll send it to the Ajay Rupani, he will send you. This is a page number 38, where all the layout design rules are written. I'll advise you all to go through it, because this is something which you have to cram, you have to learn. So let me move forward and tell you how to, you know, use it. Once you design, once you learn that, see, this is a diagram that you have to go through first. This is nothing but you may say it is a PMOS or NMOS, or I'll say this is a totally, this is a MOS, this is the only transistor. Now let us draw this here. See, this you have to learn first, and I'll advise you all, you know, to draw this in your notebook also, so that you can understand this better. See, there are 2 terminals in every MOS, and there is 1 poly or channel, you may say, like this, like here it is mentioned, you know, this is a channel, this is the difference, this is the distance of, you know, contact through the to a channel, and this is the distance from its active region. Likewise, here also the same thing. And this is what we call contact. This is a contact, and this is a channel. Okay. Now the thing is, you have to learn each and every terms in the terms of lambda, and that is I told you page number 38. There all rules are mentioned that this distance is 2 lambda. This distance is minimum 3 lambda, means you minimum it is 3 lambda, and rest you can make it as large as possible, because minimum you have to take it 3 lambda. Similarly, the contact width is 1 lambda. This is also 1 lambda. So these rules you have to be, you know, learn through that particular page 38. What are the distances in the terms of lambda you have to understand. Now, this is a simple layout of a MOS. MOS, if somebody ask me what is this MOS, is it a NMOS or PMOS? Depending upon the substrate that you choose, that is the NMOS or PMOS that we categorize. I think you already read this, otherwise we will explain it later on, but this is a MOS, right? In MOS, if we are talking about a PMOS, you know, I think everybody knows in PMOS, this is what we call VDD, and this is what we call ground if we placed it in a circuit. So this is a drain, this is a source, and this is a gate. So here if we are talking about here in this layout, so this is basically used as a gate, the red color, the strip that I marked with the red color, that is what we call channel, or we use this terminal as a gate. And you know, in PMOS or NMOS, any MOS, source and drain we can interchangeable. We can use this terminal as a source, or we can use this terminal as a source. But if you make one as a source, definitely the other will be the drain. So I hope you understand till this thing. Now let me come to the layout design. So before designing a layout, you must have to understand this. This is very important. This is a 3 lambda, and if anybody have a problem, like from where I pick this 2 lambda, 3 lambda, 1 lambda, that is page number 38. You have to read it carefully, right? So let me go forward and tell you how to design the actual layer. Now, see, this is again page number 43 your CAN book. Now, see, this is a complete layout of a CMOS inverter. So how CMOS inverter works, I think you all are aware about that. If you don't know, then we will cover it, or Ajay will cover it in, you know, subsequent sections. So here, this is a PMOS and this is a NMOS. As you all know, in CMOS there are two things. Let me design here. CMOS structure is very easy. You have one PMOS and you have one NMOS, and there are certain very, very important questions. So you please see this, otherwise I'll put it on my channel. My questions are, number one is, why we use PMOS at the, you know, driver side, a load side, and NMOS at the driver side? And another question is very important is, why PMOS is connected to always VDD and NMOS is always connected to ground? This is very important. We will discuss it later on. So this is basically a circuit of, you know, CMOS inverter, where there is a PMOS as well as this is an NMOS. Now we want to design its layout. So definitely, first of all, we have to understand in a circuit there are two things. One is PMOS and another is NMOS, means there are two MOS. And I already told you this is one of the rough diagram that I designed for a MOS. It is not a PMOS, it is not a NMOS, but it is a simply MOS. So one MOS can be represented by this as in a layout. And while designing a layout, you should have to mention it in the terms of lambda, because we are using lambda rules, you know, worldwide, because this is a standard system. And lambda is basically what? Lambda is your minimum feature size. If you are talking about the nanometer, then you can choose lambda as a nano. If it depends on the technology, what lambda you choose. So this is now let me come to the circuit. See, this is a PMOS that I designed earlier on my board. Similarly, this is NMOS. Let us suppose this is NMOS. And while designing this, you must have to take care about, you know, this width. It is 1 lambda. This is 1 lambda. This is 3 lambda. This is again 2 lambda. See, two MOSes that we designed, both are of same size, and we set it PMOS and we set this as an NMOS. This also the distance. And why this is N well? I'll tell you. See, the substrate we have not defined it. Whether it is if we choose an N substrate, so you have to be careful. Whenever you design any CMOS level layout, you must have to capture it with N well. Now why N well? I think you undergo with all the steps of the fabrication. If you don't, then you just go and learn the fabrication steps. I will not able to cover it here, but if you want, I will prepare a video and put it on my channel. But still, you just learn this on PMOS, because see, this is a whole sheet of polysilicon, so make it inactive. Otherwise, both are same substrate. So that's why we put it N well. N well is nothing but it's on a P substrate. If you put a N covering, that is what we call N well. So mind it, you have to put it, and there is a minimum distance for that also. You have to take care. Again, page number 38. You have to choose page number 38. What is the minimum distance of this? I think it is 3 lambda. So 3 lambda, you have to be keep apart all the distances from this active region. Similarly, there is also a mentioning of this rule, how much it is different. What is the minimum distance of this inactive and with this inactive. So all the distances are mentioned in page number 38. You just go and go through it, and what are the minimum features, you just have to put it here. Now let me design here this complete for you. This is a, let us suppose, this is a PMOS. For the sake of convenience, I'm using this only. And let us suppose we take care about minimum size, minimum distance of this. We'll take care about this end, and we place two more terminals over here, and a channel. See, for a channel, you can use a single channel, the same channel throughout in the both, because both are polysilicon. So we used it a single gate across both. Now how to design a, okay, let me see you. Yeah, now what you have to do, this is the gate which is common to both. The gate is connected, that's why I use a single gate. And again, for a N well, you have to put a mask here like this. I put it dotted with the blue color. This is a N well, like gridded N well. So you have to take care of this distance as well as this distance while designing a layout. Now see this circuit, the CMOS circuit. In CMOS circuit, you have to learn this. This is your drain and this is your source. Always means the drain is what? Drain is a terminal through which we take an output. Similarly here, this is a drain, this is a source. For a NMOS, mind it, as source is always, or substrate is always connected to the ground. I think you learn this. Otherwise you search this answer, you are wrong. Or I will tell you later why this in NMOS the substrate is always grounded, and in PMOS the substrate is always connected to VDD. That's why the source is always connected to the VDD, and in NMOS the source is always connected to the ground. So this is your NMOS, this one is your NMOS, and this one is your PMOS. So first of all, you have to see this structure, and here while designing a layout, what you have to do, you have to create one building over here and create one ground. Just wait. Create one ground layer here. This is the ground. This is, let us suppose, ground, and this is what you call VDD. Now you have to make all the contacts, right? Now see here, the source of PMOS means this is connected to VDD. So you just have to connect it with the VDD, and must care about, you know, all the distances, like this distance must be 1 lambda, and this is also 1 lambda. So you have to be very careful about mentioning the size here. Similarly, since you connected this source to the VDD, and this is a drain, and let us suppose this is a drain. Now you have to connect these two drains together, okay, like this. I created, connected, and we you know, taken care about the width. This is very important. And place one contact button here. This is what we call V out. Through this, you may take out. Like here, the two drains. These two drains are shorted, and output is taken from here. And rest. What about this source? Source of NMOS. This is a source. Source of NMOS is, you know, connected with the ground. So you just have to connect it with the ground like this. Now only one thing is left, that from where we have to provide V in. Now V in provided to the, you know, gates. So this is polysilicon gate basically. So you have to be taken this as in here and prepare one contact here, that is for your being. So this is a complete layout of CMOS inverter. So I'll show you in your book from where you can, you know, read it easily. This page number 44. See, the same thing I did. I connected both drains. These are the drains basically. These terminals are the drains. I connected two drains, and from here I will take an output. You may ask me, sir, you created a contact here, but here it is not created. See, you may create a contact. Through a contact, you can connect it with, you know, with the other devices. So you may create or not create it. It's up to you. But I'll advise you to just create a contact over here that is used for, you know, taking an output. And the source is connected with the VDD, and this is very important. And you have to create an annual contact also. I missed it, I think, here. Yes, I missed it. You have to create a contact for in between the annual also, because annual is already also connected with the VDD. You have to create this contact always. This you have to do always in all CMOS circuit. You have to connect it with annual VDD. And this is an input, this is a ground. And someone, you have one question in your mind. Sir, you created ground strip at the bottom and VDD at the top, but here they are not showing it. But see, practically, always we created a common ground and common VDD. That's why we created a, you know, at the bottom and at the top. So this is all about a layout of a CMOS. It is very easy to design. I'll explain it again. But the only thing is you have to be taken care of all the rules. In the exam, if somebody asks you to design a layout of CMOS inverter, so you have to design it like this, and you have to mention all the, you know, distance through, what are the distances in terms of lambda. You have to mention here like this. This is a 1 lambda, and this distance must be 2 lambda, 3 lambda. For that, you have to refer page number 38. So you have to learn all, and you mentioned it, the sizes and everything here. This is what we call layout. I think I am able to clear the concept of the layout to you, how the layout of a particular inverter get, you know, designed. Now come to the point of stick diagram. Now how stick diagram is different from this. So before designing a stick diagram, you must have to understand, stick diagram is a rough diagram, so there is no dimension is needed. You just have to clear picture of a circuit in your mind. That is, this is a V out, this is VDD, this is ground, the both the gates are, you know, shorted. This is VN, right? This is a PMOS, this is NMOS, this is PMOS and NMOS. Now, how to design a stick diagram? It is very easy. See, first of all, you have to design a one line and called it VDD. Design a bottom line, called it ground. And since there is one PMOS and an NMOS, so let us take a strip and call it PMOS. And P substrate, or take a substrate called NMOS. And there is a, you know, there is a one, only one. Since there are two transistor we used, so this is a gate, this is a gate. And now source and drain in our hand. So let me take it source, this is drain, this is source, this is drain. This is for PMOS, this is for NMOS. Now, you just have to connect according to, you know, the figure. This is source drain. Always in NMOS, the lower one is source, above one is drain. And for PMOS, this one is drain, this one is source. This is a question that I asked you also. Just go and search why we connected in PMOS, why we connected source always with the VDD, why we connected in NMOS, the source is always to the ground. So, while after that, you just have to, you know, this is a common structure. And now you have to make the connections. The source is connected with the VDD. This is the PMOS source connected with the VDD. The source of the NMOS is connected with the ground. Just connect this with the ground. And connect these two drains together, okay? And take an output from here, Vout. And this is your VIN. This is a simple stick diagram of a CMOS inverter. The only difference lies in CMOS stick diagram, and the layout is that it has a proper dimension in the terms of lambda you have to show in your exam. But while designing a stick diagram, you need not to be bothered about the dimensions, you just have to make the connections. So I hope I am able to present this clearly. Now let me do one more practical question for you so that you can understand this better. So very quickly, I'll move a NAND gate. I'll design a NAND gate for you. Before starting, let me ask Ajay, NAND gate padha diya kya aapne? If anybody asks any question to me,
किसी का कोई doubt हो तो पूछ लो mic unmute करके. Anybody having any doubt can ask by unmuting your mic now. Otherwise, sir is going forward to NAND gate. किसी को कोई doubt है क्या बेटा? तो chat box में type कर दो या फिर mic unmute करके पूछ सकते हो आप.
No problem. किसी को कोई भी doubt हो, किसी भी तरीके का कोई भी doubt है, they may ask me. I am more happy to, you know, answer it. Anybody? हाँ अजय तो बोल ही रहा है. Anybody please? अच्छा इसमें सबसे अच्छा नहीं, इसमें से नहीं ऐसे नहीं चलेगा. तो okay, let me ask somebody. इसमें सबसे intelligent बच्चा कौन सा?
इसमें सबसे intelligent बच्चा है मिनल दवे है सर.
चलो जी मिलन दवे. Yes मिलन. Just unmute yourself.
सुमन चौधरी,
just unmute yourself. Suman Chaudhary. Okay, Suman का mic नहीं चल रहा
है. Mic नहीं चल रहा है sir.
Okay. Anybody? यार देखो अगर question नहीं पूछा ना तो कोई फायदा नहीं है आपको, कुछ समझ नहीं आएगा.
पूछेंगे सर.
वॉलंटरी एनीबॉडी. देखते हैं किसके अंदर ज्यादा कर्ज है.
क्वेश्चन व्हाट्सएप पे पूछते हैं सर स्टूडेंट.
मुस्कान, डू यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम? नहीं है मुस्कान को भी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है। अरे कोई भी अपना अनम्यूट करके बात नहीं कर सकता? आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक टू यू एनीबडी।
सर समझ में आ रहा है सबको बट वो कोई अनम्यूट नहीं कर रहा है सर।
कोई बात नहीं, ओके, लेट मी मूव फॉरवर्ड, सी, नैंड गेट इज व्हाट, ओके, आई क्विकली डिजाइन इट, यू नो, सर्किट फर्स्ट इन नैंड गेट, यू नो, द आउटपुट इज वाई इज इक्वल टू ए डॉट बी बार, दिस इज द आउटपुट, ओके। And if we are talking about its circuits, the driver is, your load is like this, this is VDD, and this is your, this is A, this is B, NMOS, this is ground, and from here we take an output, V out, this is A, this is B, very simple. Now, see this is ground. Now I told you, in NMOS, this is S, this is D, this is S, this is D, because always, you know, source is always connected with the ground. So this is source, this is drain, alternatively this is source, this is a drain. Now here these two are the drains and these two are the source, because in N, in the PMOS these are different, sources are always connected to the VDD. So now let me design its stick diagram first. Stick diagram kaise banayenge iska? Very simple, you just have to create a strip VDD, create a strip here. That is a line, you might draw a line, ground. Now there are, you know, again, this is a PMOS or this is NMOS. It depends upon us whether we design a strip or create a line. It do not have any problem. This is a PMOS, this is a NMOS, right? Now what you have to do, see there are two NMOS and two PMOS. So while taking this strip, this is a one, and this is gate for one pair. And this is a gate for another pair. Now this is very interesting. See, जितने आपको transistor के pair हो ना, आप उतने ये बना लीजिएगा, क्योंकि ये एक transistor बन गया. Now this is source, this is drain, this is source, this is drain, तो दो transistor बन गए. Similarly, source, drain, तो एक और transistor बन गया हमारे पास. Now what you have to do? See, these two sources you have to connect it to the VDD. So I'll take this drain, this is source. This is source, this is drain. It's up to me. Why I'm taking these two sources together? Because these two sources together, we have to, you know, connect it with the VDD. So I just shorted it and connected with the VDD. It is very easy. Rather than, you know, if you take source here and source here, then you have to connect them first and then you have to connect it to the VDD. And that will, you know, require more metal for interconnection. But here, if these two are shorted, you just have need one strip to, you know, just connect it to the VDD. This is what we call, you know, orientation or optimization of the design. So must have you, it's up to you whether you have to take these two sources together or aap kenge sir agar hum yahan pe source aur drain le le, whether it is wrong. No, it is not wrong, but the structure is not optimized. Now we talk about the two drains. See, agar aapne sources ko pass le liye to drain dur ho gaye, to baat to wahi ho gayi. Now you have to connect two drains. So I take this drain, this is source, drain source, and then drain source. Now these two drains ko aapko upar wale dono drains ko short karke niche ke drain se milana hai, to in dono drains ko aapne short kar diya aur isko niche drain se mila diya aur yahan se aapne output le liya. This is V out, right? Aur V in aapne kisko dena hai? This is A, this is B, kyunki ye A wale aur B wale hain, to aapne in dono A aur B ko आपको आपको करना क्या है, आपको एक ए का आउटपुट, एक ए से इनपुट देना है और एक बी से देना है. तो ये आप बाहर एक बी ए और बी बी ऐसे लिख देंगे कि दो इनपुट है हमारे पास. बिकॉज यहाँ पे भी आप देखें तो आप ये दोनों बी ए को शॉर्ट करके बी ए लिखेंगे और इन दोनों बी बी को शॉर्ट करके बी बी लिखेंगे. तो मैंने क्या किया है, मैंने एक वी और बी बी ये दो आउटपुट ले लिए. ऊपर के कनेक्शन मेरे हो गए, नीचे के रह गए हैं. नीचे मेरे को इस सोर्स को ग्राउंड करना है, तो मैं इसके सोर्स को ग्राउंड कर देता हूँ, ठीक है. और ये ड्रेन सोर्स कनेक्टेड है, देखिए ड्रेन सोर्स कनेक्टेड है और ऊपर के तीन ड्रेन आपस में शॉर्टेड है, ये ऊपर के तीन ड्रेन ऊपर में शॉर्टेड है. सो दिस इज अ सिंपल स्टिक डायग्राम, दिस इज सिंपल स्टिक डायग्राम फॉर अ नैंड गेट, वेरी इजी. नाउ इफ यू हैव टू, यू नो, कनेक्ट, इफ यू वांट टू ड्रॉ अ कंप्लीट लेआउट, तो आपको कुछ नहीं करना. देखिए ऑलरेडी मैंने ये PMOS का ये मैंने ऑलरेडी स्ट्रिप्स ले ली थी. यू जस्ट हैव टू, यू नो, मेक अ कॉन्टैक्ट्स. आप यहाँ पे कॉन्टैक्ट्स बनाइए ऐसे करके, लेआउट में बता रहा हूँ कैसे बनाना है. कॉन्टैक्ट के ऊपर आप ऐसे करके इसके ऊपर कवर चढ़ाइए जो कवर आपको लेना है लैम्डा साइज के अकॉर्डिंगली, और इसको आप यहाँ पे भी ऐसे कवरिंग करते हुए नीचे से आप इसको ऐसे कवर करते हुए यू क्रिएट अ वी आउट हियर, दिस इज वी आउट सिंपल। एंड फॉर हियर आल्सो यू हैव टू क्रिएट लाइक दिस एंड लाइक दिस, यू हैव टू क्रिएट अ कॉन्टैक्ट हियर एंड कॉन्टैक्ट हियर। And one thing is more that I forgot, if you have to design, if this is a layout, you have to create a anvil that I told you at in the initially, you have to create an anvil also. And this source, you have to create just a box over the source, create a button here, contact here and here. And this will become your layout. So it is very easy to, you know, convert a stick diagram to layout. On a layout, if you create a if you put the dimensions and everything, then it will become a layout. This is how your layout and stick diagram can be made. So let me take one more example quickly. Last example, NOR gate. If you want to create a layout for a NOR gate, now NOR gate is what? In the NOR gate, there are two PMOS like here A and B, and two NMOS here. This is A, this is B, and this is ground. So again, source drain. This is very important to mention. This is drain source. Now very easy, very quickly we will create this is a VDD strip. Stick diagram, first of all I'll create VDD, and this is a ground, and here it is a PMOS layer, and this is a NMOS layer. Again, there, since there are two pairs A and B, so we take two polys A and B. Now the only thing left is we have to make the connections. Very easy. This is source drain. Very simple, you can write it like this, source drain. ऑप्टिमाइजेशन बाद में करते रहिएगा, पहले इसको ऐसे सिंपल बनाना सीखे। सोर्स को वीडीडी से कनेक्ट करना है, आई यूज अ रेड पेन। सोर्स को आप वीडीडी से कनेक्ट कर दीजिए, ड्रेन सोर्स आपस में कनेक्टेड है, ड्रेन सोर्स कनेक्टेड है। नाउ तीनों के ड्रेन आपको शॉर्ट करने हैं, तो ड्रेन और एक जे वाला ड्रेन, यू जस्ट टेक इट लाइक दिस एंड टेक इट आउटसाइड पी आउट, and then you have to short these two sources and make it ground. So I'll advise you to take this drain, this is source, because these two sources, you know, together we can connect it to the ground. And here connect this, these three drains. I'll make it with the red pen, blue pen. This drain connected and take it out. So this is how the strip diagram is prepared. The strip diagram is okay because see, you can check it, two sources connected with the ground, all the three drains together connected with the V out. So all the three drains together, they connected with the V out. Now drain source, this is a source which is connected to the VDD, source connected to the VDD, drain source are connected with each other, and this drain is, you know, shorted with this. Now further, if you want to convert this stick diagram into layout, I told you what you have to do. You just have to, you know, create a strip by taking care of lambda rules, and you can easily have your layout diagram. So I hope I am able to clarify doubt between layout and stick diagram. Anybody have any question? You may ask me. Ajay, यहाँ तक समझ में आ गया?
Yes sir, आ गया sir, यहाँ तक आ गया.
Right. So in this way, you know, I'll give you some questions, like maybe in the exam you have a question like A plus B, C plus D. Draw its layout and the stick diagram. Similarly, AB plus CD. These two questions I'll give as a, you know, home task to everybody. if they have any problem, they may ask me. Otherwise, they can design this and send me across my WhatsApp. I'll check it, or you checked it, whether they designed it correct or not.
Yes, sir.
Right.
एक सर इनको तीन इनपुट्स का बता दीजिए सर. थ्री इनपुट का स्टैक डायग्राम दो, नॉर या नैंड कोई भी.
ये लो ये तीन इनपुट ही हैं, इनफैक्ट चार हैं. ये चलो मैं आपके लिए तीन इनपुट का ले लेता हूँ. y is equal to a plus b into c. ये इसका बनाएं
इसका डायग्राम और लेआउट समझा दीजिए.
ठीक है जी. देखिए आप क्या करिए, आप लेट अस डिजाइन दिस सर्किट फर्स्ट. How to design this circuit, I think you are able to know, because I generally designed the bottom first. That is what we call driver. Yes, I designed the driver first. So for driver, these are A plus B, that is NOR gate. So this is A and this is B. Now this will give you A plus B, and you have to product it with C. So that is, this is a product with C. So this is A, this is B, and this is a C. I hope you understand how to design the circuit. और अभी इसके ऊपर हम इसका उल्टा बनाते हैं. आपको A और D को तो ऐसे दिखाना है, A and D, और C को इसके साथ पैरेलल में दिखाना है. ये सर्किट तो बनाना आता है ना, सर्किट तो बनाना आता है इन लोगों को?
यस सर, यस सर्किट बनाना आता है सर.
ओके. नाउ दिस इज VDD. Now the same thing you have to do. This is source, this is drain. This is source, this is source, this is drain, this is drain. And here also, this is drain, this is drain, this is source, then drain, then source. Now, very easy. I'll draw the stick diagram. This is VDD. This is ground. This is PMOS. This is NMOS. Now you have to be, see, there are six transistors, so means three inputs. So we take three, three strips, three polysilicon gate, three gate strip. This is A, this is B, and this one is C. This is A, this is B, this is C. Now we just have to do the connections, no problem. See, this is A, this is B, this is C. Now for the C, the source, let us suppose this is a source. Source is ground, okay, make it ground. And then drain, and the sources of the two. So the sources of the two, okay, initially we will take like this, source, drain, like this, right? Now the two drains we have to connect with the above two drains. So we will take it source, drain, source. Now these two drains and lower bottom two drains like this. I'll take another color green. These two drains, this is your output. See, D. Here also D. You shorted them and taken out like this, right? Similarly, this is a source that you connected with the ground. So this is okay. Now drain is connected with the four drains we together connected like this, right? Okay. Now source, drain, and what about this drains? These two sources. Okay. We have to connect two sources with the drain. These two sources with the drain. So I'll change this. This is source and this is drain. Now see, two sources connected with the drain, right? And these are the two drains which are shorted. Now what about this drain? This has no connection. This has no connection. This drain is already connected with the two sources. So this is okay. Now talk about the PMOS. This source you have to connect it with the VDD, okay? And this is connected with the drain, and then source, and then drain. It's okay. And again, this source you have to connect it with the VDD. तो आपने ये सोर्स को भी VDD से कनेक्ट कर दिया, ये वाले सोर्स को भी VDD से कनेक्ट कर दिया. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस लेआउट स्टिक डायग्राम. इसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. एनी क्वेश्चन? दिस इज द वी आउट, दिस इज योर वी आउट. And if you want to make a layout, you just put the contact buttons and take care about the lambda rules. See, again, this is the source. This is the source that you connected with the ground. You connected with the ground. This is a drain. This is a drain. And this drain, or otherwise you can, you know, you can create a button. You need not to be reshuffled it. You can create a button and connect it. Create a contact and connect it. Like this, you can also do it. Here, this is drain, and these are the two sources. With this drain, these are the two sources. Yes. Yes, anybody have any question? Ajay?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
किसी को कोई क्वेश्चन पूछना हो तो डाउट हो तो पूछ लो बेटा अभी. एनीवन हैविंग एनी डाउट कैन आस्क नाउ. किसी को डाउट नहीं है डायोड के अंदर? यस सर, कोई डाउट नहीं है सर.
ठीक है, ये तो बहुत अच्छी क्लास है. देखो, दो 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 लोगों को डाउट नहीं होता. एक तो वो जिनको 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 सब समझ में आ रहा हो, और एक वो जिनको जिनको कुछ भी समझ में ना आ रहा हो. आई होप दे आर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी. इनको सब कुछ समझ में आ गया होगा. इफ एनी हाउ इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी क्वेरी, यू आर नॉट फीलिंग कंफर्टेबल ओवर हियर टू आस्क मी, सो आई प्रोवाइड यू नो माय ईमेल आईडी. यू मे आस्क मी एनी टाइम एनी क्वेश्चन टू मी. दिस इज माय ईमेल आईडी, पवन बिग whig@gmail.com. You may ask me any question anytime, right? I am more happy to help you all. This is my email ID, right? And you need not to be worried. We will record it.